Hello everyone, welcome back. You probably noticed that I look the same tonight as I did in last night's video. Well, that's because I filmed them both on the same night. So pardon my still wet hair, I had just gotten back from the gym before I started filming, so I had to get a shower. So that said, let's get into tonight's review. It should be Halloween day when this comes out. To be honest, if this had released earlier, I very well may have mustered up the strength to do this review sooner because I really enjoyed the book. So you might have had a wheezing review, but this book did not come out until the 27th. So I did need a chance to read it and, you know, more than once, all that fun stuff. So let's get into it. The books that we are reviewing today is Spookily Yours by Jennifer Chipman. So there is, oh, there's a good angle. So this is the story of Willow and Damien. Willow is a witch. She and her sister, who is also a witch, live in a little witch town just outside of Salem, Massachusetts. So it's a town of witches, which is super fun. They kind of lean into it a little bit, and of course this happens around Halloween time. So Willow goes to the animal rescue to see if there is a cat or dog there that would be a familiar for her, and she ends up adopting a cute little black cat named Damien. Well, imagine her surprise to find out that Damien is in fact not a cat, but a demon who has been cursed to remain in his cat form. Willow, being a very kind-hearted young witch, helps him to break his spell, and once he is returned to his original form, Damien realizes that Willow is his mate. However, he has been sent by his brother, who is the prince of the demons, to find his brother's mate. And that kind of becomes a problem, at least in his mind, because his mate, or his brother's mate more accurately, is someone who is very close to Willow and important to Willow. So throughout the entirety of the story, he is trying to keep his distance because he's scared what's going to happen if once he's finally done his mission to bring his brother's mate to him, that Willow will not want to have anything to do with him. So he's trying to build trust, get her understanding, so that when the time comes, maybe she'll be more accepting and understanding of things and realize that he didn't really have a choice because there is a bond between him and his brother, to where he basically has to do what his brother says. And then, of course, Willow, she knows that she is attracted to Damien. She knows she has feelings for him. Because she is not a demon herself, she's a little bit slower to the concept of being, of admitting that she is in love with him and is destined to be with him. Because she doesn't understand that apparently demons have mates. She, amongst which kind, there's a lot of false ideas about demons, what they can and cannot do. So she's pretty positive that at the end of the month he's going to leave. And so she's trying to not get too close to him too quick, so that she doesn't get hurt when he leaves, which makes total sense to me. And then, of course, by the end of the story, the truth comes out about the fact that they are mates, about the fact that his brother's mate is somebody close to her, and, you know, the fact that they're going to have to live in the demon realm, right? And it's a lot for her to get used to, but she does. It's a cute story. It's not full of a lot of action. It doesn't really have a whole lot of violence. I think there's like maybe one or two punches in the entire story. So it's not super dramatic. I would basically say this is kind of like a Hallmark Halloween movie, but with demons. So if you can visualize that, that's pretty good representation. They do really good on creating a fall feeling to it, because again, it's a town of witches. So you have the witch vibe going on. Because they're all witches, they lean very heavily into Halloween and Samhain and all of those things. So you get lots of like imagery of pumpkins. The amount of pumpkin flavored foods in this story are bordering on crazy. I mean, I love pumpkin spice, but dang, I think I'd go a little crazy with the amount of pumpkin that they have in this story. And then of course you have the black cat, the demon, all these wonderful things. It's super fun. There is a little bit more depth to it than I thought going in. So Luna is Willow's sister and co-owner in their bakery. Luna's been trying to get Willow to kind of come out of her shell a little bit. When Willow had been away at college, their parents had died in a car accident. And so Willow came home to take care of her younger sister, Luna. And she still lives in the house that her parents left to them. And she really never really branched out, so to speak. She's never been one to really want to make a lot of decisions. She doesn't really like a lot of change. It's kind of unclear if that is a result of her parents dying in a car accident, or if that's just how she's always been, or maybe a mixture of the two. So there's that aspect, and she's been very lonely, and that's part of why she wanted to go get a cat as a familiar. And then Damien probably has has considerably more backstory for some very obvious reasons and some not so obvious reasons. Damien, of course, is a demon who is here to do the bidding of his brother. So he's pretty old. He's a few hundred years old, I believe, if I'm correct. His brother, who is the Prince of Demons, is in fact his younger brother. And the reason his younger brother is the Crown Prince is because, Damien is in fact an illegitimate son born out of wedlock, whereas the younger brother is born in wedlock and therefore is the one who will ascend to the throne. And it's very clear that there's an element of not knowing his purpose before his younger brother came of an age to start having more of a hands-on involvement in the running of the demon realm. Damien had basically been their father's right-hand man, but now his younger brother is at an age where he has to take more hands-on approach. He's having to take on more and more responsibility until the time comes for him to take over. So now Damien, who's used to having all these things to do, is basically an errand boy for his younger brother. You get in a little bit of backstory about how his mother, who had been a shifter, had been murdered. It's never really made clear by who or why. I mean, you kind of get an idea of why, but it's not really cemented in there. There's a couple interactions between Damien and his brother. And you kind of get this feeling that there's a resentment of the younger brother towards Damien, but he still cares about his brother. And Damien just kind of feels like, why do you have me here? So you do get some really interesting backstory. You get some really interesting character development, both learning to trust each other, learning to care about each other. And while at the same time battling wanting each other because they think that they can't be together because of all these extenuating circumstances. And then when they do come together, it's really nice. It's just them being together and being a couple and being happy. And you get a nice little epilogue at the end where it's her and Damien have now gotten married. They've had a daughter. They're talking about having another child. And apparently Damien's brother will actually come and visit every so often with this person who is important to Willow, who is his destined mate. I'm proud of myself for not giving away who it was, because I thought I was going to mess up on that one. But it's a cute story. It's a very fun, warm read. Like, if you want an evening at home where you're having a pumpkin spice latte or apple cider or something like that, and just in your cozy blanket, definitely the book for it. I think it'd be really great. It's fun, it's cute, it's festive, and it will definitely keep you in the Halloween spirit. So I hope you enjoy this review. I hope you found it helpful. Please let me know in the comments down below if there's any specific stories that you think you would like for me to try next year for Hauntober. Hopefully we don't have the respiratory issue next year and I can actually do a full Hauntober like I usually do. So I'll see you all at the next review. Hopefully it will not be more than a week away, but I'll see you all then. Bye-bye.